atomicity, you write down the next property. What do you mean by atomicity? Atomicity of nitrogen is what? The atomicity of nitrogen is, it is a diatomic molecule, right? And to write down, nitrogen is a diatomic molecule its bond order is 3, because we know N2 molecule exists like this. Nitrogen has 3-1 triple bond and 1-1 lone pair on each nitrogen. It has 1 sigma bond and 2 pi. One sigma and 2 pi. Okay. Next line, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony exist in exist as tetraatomic molecule. Tetraatomic molecule like P4, SB4, AS4, like that. Okay. Right on, these elements are not capable of forming multiple bond. Okay. Capable of forming multiple bond because of the large size of orbital. So P4 structure, you see, it has a tetrahedron structure where exists or placed at the corner of a tetrahedron like this. Okay. This angle is what? This angle is 60 degrees. Yes, 60 degrees. P4. Can you tell me the valence electron in P4 molecule? Total valence electron? In one phosphorus atom, how many valence electron we have? 5. So we have P4. So 5 into 4. So P4 has 20 valence electron. Okay. This is one. Now we see the type of compounds that these element forms. Okay, so write down next thing. Chemical reactivity, you write down the heading. Chemical reactivity. Okay, the first type of compound that we are going to discuss here is the hydrides, the formation of hydrides. Okay, write down the elements of group 15 forms hydride of MH3 type. Like we have NH3, PH3, ASH3. SbH3 and BiH3. Okay, this type of hydride forms. Okay, so all these hydrides has 3 bond pair and 1 lone pair, correct? All of you know this, right? That's why the steric number is 4 And hybridization is what? SP3. Hybridization is SP3. Geometry and what is the geometry? Geometry tetrahedron. Shape. Shape is trigonal pyramidal. Under what case geometry and shape will be same? Can you tell me? Anyone?
When there are no lone pairs.
When there is no lone pair present. When the lone pair is zero, then whatever the geometry we have, that will be the shape of the molecule also. Right? That you must take care of. Okay. Now, like I said, hydrides, they form these type of hydrides. Now, there are various properties of hydride, which is very important. Okay. And they usually ask questions from these only. Chemical reactivity. Hydrides ka ho gaya, halides ka ho gaya, oxides ka ho gaya. These are the most important part here. Okay. Whatever we have discussed, property, boiling point and all, that is also important, but this one is more important. Okay. So first property of hydrides, write down, and that we are going to discuss here is bond angle. Bond angle bahut baar pucha exam. Bond angle. You see the bond angle here. I'll write down the molecule first. We have NH3, PH3, ASH3, SBH3, and BIH3. These are the compounds. The exact bond angle, if I write down, it is 949, NH3, it is 933.6. Okay. For ASH3, it is 91.8. For PH3, it is, just a second, I made a mistake here. For NH3, it is maximum. NH3, it is 107 point something, approximately 107, I'm assuming. And this is 93.6. This is 91.3, and this one is 90. As we go down the group, you see bond angle decreases. Okay. Values you don't have to memorize. Let me tell you. Okay. Values you don't have to memorize. Trend you should know. So as we go down the group, bond angle of hydrides decreases. Okay. And why this happens? Size is a factor. Size is a factor. We have the size is a factor. Electronegativity is also a factor. One thing, also one general thing you write down here. Note, I have done this last year in chemical bonding, if you remember. As the electronegativity of central atom increases, bond angle increases. See, the difference in these molecules are what? NH3, PH3, ASH3, SBH3, BIH3. The difference is the central atom, correct? Sabhi to hydrides hai. The only central atom is different. Okay. And the central atom has different electronegativity also, correct? So what you have to keep in mind, as the electronegativity of central atom increases, bond angle increases. This is the general thing you should know. Why this happens, that also you can understand. I'll write down here, you see. Electronegativity is what? Electronegativity is tendency to attract shared pair of electrons. Shared pair of electrons. Lone pair ko nahi dekhte hain. Okay. Tendency to attract shared pair of electrons. So nitrogen has three bond pair like this and one lone pair. Yahan pe hai. Okay. So since the electronegativity of nitrogen is maximum, one more molecule I'll draw here, PH3. Okay. The electronegativity of nitrogen is more than that of phosphorus. So what happens? This bond pair of electron is very close to this nitrogen atom here. Comparatively, it is shifted towards the nitrogen atom. Yes or no? In comparison to this phosphorus, where the atom electrons will be somewhere here, not as close as the electrons are there in the case of nitrogen. Okay. Now, when these goes to this center, then obviously these two electrons will have some repulsion. They are coming closer, right? Say they are coming, they are going close to each other, right? That's why they feel more repulsion. So the bond angle increases there to minimize the repulsion. That's why the electronegativity of the central atom increases. It drags the electron towards its side, and hence these electrons experience more repulsion. And to minimize this, the bond angle increases. That's why we say as the electronegativity of central atom increases, bond angle also increases. Okay. Values, like I said, you don't have to memorize. Trend you must know. Clear?
So what does BiH3 look like?
Sorry?
What does BiH3 look like with a 90 degree bond angle?
BiH3, you said. BH3. BiH3.
Yeah.
BiH3 is same, no? The bond angle is 90 degree, correct? So this, what happens here? Bi is this, okay? And these bonds are almost at 90 degree to each other. Like this. Here we have one lone pair. All these are nitrogens. So H, H, and H. So it's formed a triangle here, right? And a lone pair here, the trigonal pyramidal structure. Okay?
Yeah. Okay, yeah.
Done. Next, the second property of hydrides are thermal stability. Write down. The thermal stability of these hydrides decreases as we go down the group. And why this happens? Any guess? Thermal stability means what? Thermal stability means stability towards heat. Okay. So when you heat these molecules, all these hydrides, which one is most stable? That's the question is. Okay. Is this, hence stability decreases. Okay. Third property. Reducing agent. As we go down the group, its reducing character increases. Okay. And why this happens? Okay. Reducing agent is what? As we go down the group, its reducing characteristics increases. Okay. Why reducing characteristics increases? Because it is related to thermal stability, actually. Why this? Thermal stability. Reducing nature is what? Tendency to lose hydride ion. Okay. So write down the reducing nature. Reducing nature is a tendency to release hydrogen. To release hydrogen. So as we go down the group, the thermal stability decreases. The molecules becomes less stable. Then the atom hydrogen bond can break easily and hydrogen can go out. That's why the reducing behavior increases as we go down the group. So BiH3 is the best reducing agent out of the five here. Okay. Reducing behavior, I'll write down the order. NH3 is minimum, then PH3, then ASH3 SBH3 and then BIH3 must remember this also. Basic character, next one. Basic character. As we go down the group, the basic character decreases. Okay. The reason of this is what? Basic character is nothing but a tendency to lose electron. Okay. Tendency to lose electron will be more when the electron density is high. Okay. Electron density means what? Suppose we have, I'm comparing nitrogen and phosphorus. Okay. Basic character of this. So nitrogen ke saath we have NH3, phosphorus we also have NH3. We have to actually find out the tendency for these molecules to lose this lone pair of electron, which is present on the central atom. And that is a Lewis base behavior, right? Nitrogen size is lesser than to that of phosphorus. Okay. So electron density in case of nitrogen is more or less more. So electron density is more here. It means it can easily lose electron, more electron density, more tendency to lose. That's why the basic behavior of NH3 is maximum among these hydrides. Okay. So NH3 is the strongest Lewis base out of the five here, right now, because of maximum electron density. Okay. These are the four properties, characteristics we have of these hydrides that you must remember. Now, these elements also react with oxygen and forms oxides. Okay.